Mostly the job is to ask questions. The frustrating part, the part that drives you crazy, is that the people you really want to talk to are dead.
Lieutenant?
Any idea who she is?
No. I didn't want to move her. God, it's awful.
There are grass stains on her pants. You dragged her. Did you just touch me? Wow. I had way too much coffee. Looks like there's some kind of white hair on her jacket. Maybe animal fur?
Yeah, I saw that.
Watch your step.
No. It's hers?
Yeah.
How'd you know?
He raped her and then strangled her to death.
And then put her pants back on?
That's my guess.
Ah, there you are. Here, I brought you some tea.
Thanks.
Welcome. You making a war room?
Carla had asthma. I think the cat hair was in the car. Sleeping with you.
Uh-huh. When?
Soon.
Good.
be mad.
I'm not.
Can I ask you one question?
What?
Why do you think she got in the car?
It's kind of late, honey. Why don't you give it a rest, huh?
FBI seems to agree with initial profiles. They feel there's a good chance the killer's out of state. Sloppy, low intelligence. Someone with the knowledge of Rochester resides elsewhere. Probably a marginal type personality. Okay, Megan?
He's not sloppy. He didn't choose her at random, and we're wasting our time looking for truck drivers and transients.
The guy chased her in reverse in broad daylight in front of a dozen witnesses, for Christ's sakes.
The kid got lucky for 20 seconds. He's cold and calculating, and he's gonna do it again.
No, we don't have a serial killer. He's an emotional, impulse-driven, bumbling fuck-up. He's probably 1,000 miles from here, running in terror.
What do you think, Ken?
Carla Castillo was a smart kid. I don't think she'd get into a car with anyone who looked like even a marginal transient.
I'm not saying the guy looks like fucking Leatherface. I'm saying
that the crime scene had all the earmarks of a disorganized killer.
Do you know how many people have the same first and last initial? 2%. So the killer found a way to get Carla Castillo into his car, and he drove her to Churchville. That is not random.
It might be.
It's got nothing to do with the initials.
He watched her for a long time. He waited, and he did it exactly the way he wanted to. And any loss of control he displays is intentional.
Megan, we've interviewed everybody who ever met this girl, and we've gotten nothing.
Well, please let me interview them again. Mr. Castillo?
Hey, you have news?
No, nothing concrete yet.
No. You here to see me then?
Yeah. I was hoping maybe we could talk a little more.
Can I get you something?
Hank, this lady's a police officer.
Oh, soda, something?
No, thank you.
How about some coffee? Just made it fresh.
That'd be great, thanks.
Let's go upstairs.
Okay. Was Tuesday the only day you saw Carla?
Pretty much usually. Her mother and I had a falling out. I would like to have seen her more, don't get me wrong.
And what would you do?
Have dinner, watch TV, talk.
What did she like to eat?
Do you think I had something to do with what happened to her?
No.
And why are you asking me this stuff again?
I want to find the man that hurt your daughter, Jay. I need to understand everything that was happening because anything could be important.
Spaghetti, French fries, Chinese takeout, tacos from the deli.
In some of the photos, she's wearing a medallion of some kind.
Saint Philomena, patron saint of children. Her grandmother gave her that.
I haven't found it. She wasn't wearing it, and it wasn't recovered at the scene.
Maybe she lost it.
What did she talk about when she came over?
Schoolwork. Friends. Kid stuff. Like I told you. You okay?
Yes. Sorry, what were her friends' names? Carla saw her father on Tuesdays.
Yes.
Until 6 or 7 at night.
That's right.
I spoke to the bus drivers who run that route on Tuesdays. They weren't very helpful. They couldn't remember whether or not they saw her.
Carla was a quiet girl. You might not even notice when she was in the room.
Was there anyone else she regularly visited? Other family?
No. Jay's mom. She was the only family in Rochester. She died about a month ago. We didn't get along well when she was alive. We hadn't seen her in years.
Did Carla have any older friends you might have forgotten?
You asked me all this before. I really want to help you, but I don't know how. I'm so sorry, I just don't feel good.
Okay. Do you mind if I look in her room again? Mom, what are you hiding?
I'm sorry, I was looking under the bed and I was startled.
You should go.
I apologize.
It's time for you to stop working on Castillo. It's having a bad effect on you, and people are complaining about your behavior.
What people? Look, Ray, you know I get a little bit obsessed. That's my process. And yes, I know that that can be spooky
Everyone
to some people.
Everyone has given incredible deference to your process, Meg. And because of your track record, and it may be too much, so. People say they've seen you talking to yourself.
That's bullshit.
So this is the number of my psychologist. She's been incredibly helpful to me and Sandy.
It's bullshit, Captain.
No. She's expecting your call. So what I want you to do is take the vacation time you saved up and just, you know, cool out and get a handle on things.
I'm not going to stop.
You most certainly are.
How's she doing?
Stable.
What happened?
I believe she's had what is referred to as an adult onset of schizophrenia.
Schizophrenia? How's that possible? She's been normal her whole life.
Has she had some sort of trauma recently?
Well, I mean, she was, I don't know if it was traumatic or not, but she was recently taken off the Carla Castillo investigation. What now? I mean, will she get better?
We've got a long road ahead.
It's like my brain would be trapped in a loop. There's no way to stop it. Just the same upsetting, awful thoughts over and over. I would just be racked with panic 24/7. My family has trouble understanding why I did the things I did. I guess I can't blame them, but I wish they would talk to me. Anyway, my doctor's changed the medication, and they seem to be helping again. And the lawyer says the charges might be dropped, so I guess things are looking up.
Thank you for sharing that with us. I can relate completely to your wanting your family to talk with you. I put myself in this chair by crashing my brother's Lexus into a wall. Didn't work. He still didn't speak to me. And now he's gone. But, does anybody else wanna?
Well, a lot of what Tim was saying sounded familiar. I lost my fiancé to my disease. I lost my career. I was well respected, but now I realize that a good deal of my success came from the way I would fixate when I was on a case. I guess I would go a bit manic, which would sometimes allow me an insight. I guess I was able to keep it under control, to sort of channel it for a while. But 2 years ago, I had a case that, I don't know, blew my circuits. My failure to solve it left me desolate. I couldn't get it out of my mind. I was hallucinating around it, and I couldn't imagine a time when it wasn't with me constantly. So I tried to kill myself. But now the doctors say that by doing all the right things, ignoring my ghosts, trusting my safe people, Parks and, well, you, that I have a pretty good chance at leading a more or less functional life.
So you're back at work?
Rubber gun division. They have to give me a job or the union will go after the city.
Oh.
So they have me in the records department. Or I won't get in any trouble. It's better than it sounds.
Does your ex, he still works there?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
He's made captain, so he's the boss. I have him to thank for the job. But if it weren't for you, I never would have made it out of Park Ridge.
No, that's the first dumb thing I've heard you say.
Well, then you haven't been listening. And what about you? Are you heading back to work?
No. My doctor said I have to stay away from calculators.
I know what you must have gone through. Numbers are a bitch. I used to calculate the probability of different scenarios over and over. Like the chance that the three C's were random.
Your Castillo murder case?
Yeah. Yeah. If 2% of the population have matching first and last initials, what are the chances that Carla Castillo would be dumped in a town that started with the letter C? I'd plug in different variables, but I never got a number that was lower than 1 in 1,400.
You may never know. And you may have to live with that.
You're smart, crazy Lich.
Thank you.
Where is it? Jean, it's the little girl. It's the Walsh girl.
He has 6 outstanding tickets. Yes, you can inbound his car. No problem. Hey guys, what's up?
Nothing.
Angelo, get down there, see if you can get me a witness. Go, now. Go ahead. Well, how did the press find out about that? Not now. No, go ahead, Bob, continue. What?
Wendy Walsh driven 30 miles to be killed in Webster. Why are you looking at me like that? I'm not gonna freak out.
Okay, so you were right. But that doesn't alter the fact that you...
Had a meltdown? I know. How did he strangle her? Oh, come on, Ken, how did he do it?
There hasn't been an autopsy yet.
From the marks on her neck, it doesn't look like he used his hands.
He used a belt from behind, okay? Look, Meg, this is pointless. You're not an investigator anymore.
I can help, you know it.
Look, Meg, I don't think you should take on the stress, okay?
Ken, I'm fine. Look, I'm taking medication. I know the warning signs. I'm in a support group. I'm in therapy. I'm not gonna snap. And I need to do this.
You want more coffee?
No, thank you.
Yes, fill his cup. He can't go home yet. There was cat hair, wasn't there? I knew it. I knew it last time. Let me help you, please, Ken.
You can ride with Harper on a trial basis, okay? You're a consultant only. You observe, advise, and consult. That's it. You don't conduct interviews on your own. He takes the lead. You don't handle evidence. You don't go near evidence. If we catch this guy, I don't want some defense attorney, you know, using your mental history to destroy our case. Jesus, this is a bad idea. And you don't load your weapon, all right?
Ken, this is a good idea. You want to catch him, too.
Can I finish eating now, please?
Yes.
Thank you.
You meeting Eileen?
Well, how'd you know?
Everyone knows. She's very pretty.
Thanks. Everyone in this room, you are now assigned to the task force for the Castillo-Walsh investigations full-time. I want you to clear your desk of everything else you're working on. Now, we're proceeding with the assumption that the killings were perpetrated by the same individual.
and that we are dealing with an active local serial killer. Both victims have traces of the same white cat hair on their clothing. Now, in the matter of the Walsh killing, we have jurisdiction over the kidnapping only. Since the murder took place in Webster, we're going to be sharing the case with Webster PD, who have promised to cooperate fully. Biggs, you'll be coordinating with them. Now, I want all known pedophiles in the area questioned. And I want surveillance on the dump sites, the victims' graves, and the general neighborhoods from where the girls disappeared. Now, I'm sure I don't have to remind you all to conduct yourselves calmly and professionally. Okay, that's it. Harper, let me have a word with you.
I charted everywhere Carla commonly went. Blue means by bus, red means on foot. There's gotta be some crossover with Wendy somewhere. What?
Nothing.
What's on your mind, Harper? Honesty breeds trust.
No, it doesn't.
All right, come on, just say it. What, you think I'm going to endanger you?
I think you're going to endanger this case, and possibly yourself. I think you were an excellent detective who should have accepted full disability for your mental illness. I know that the department keeps you around out of pity, and I think the captain's decision is insane, and it wouldn't happen if it weren't for your past relationship. You trust me now?
Help with this.
Honey, Captain tells me you're gonna consult, you're gonna consult. What the hell can I do about it? Just keep in the back, stay out of the way.
You think it's okay to call me honey?
No. That was inappropriate.
Apology accepted.
Was there anyone who took an unusual interest in Wendy?
Unusual, no.
Oh, she was a great kid. Everyone liked her.
She was baptized. Are you active in the church?
We went to Mass on Sundays at St. Michael's, and Wendy went to a church-sponsored camping trip last summer.
She met a friend, Zoe, there. They used to,
She and Zoe were best friends.
I'd like to make a list of all of Wendy's friends.
Oh, they're right in her cell phone. Jim, would you... Jim.
She would always forget this, and then she wouldn't be able to call me when she needed me.
Jim.
When she needed me.
Jim, let them help us, hmm? Let them help us. It's all right. It's all right.
Would you mind if I looked in Wendy's room?
No. Right up the stairs.
I just got a call. A homeless man saw the abduction.
I think I saw it, you know. I'm a witness, you know. I think I saw her as the last person to see her, you know, really. I was talking to her right before she got into the car.
What'd you talk to her about?
I needed money. Somebody stole my basket. I got no place to carry my stuff.
Did she give you money?
No.
Or what happened after she passed you?
She walked up that way and then she got into a blue car. And I didn't see anybody after that because the driver was blocked.
Do you have any idea the make of the car?
Yeah. It's blue.
Do you know what kind of blue car?
No, my eyes.
If I showed you pictures, would you be able to identify what kind of car it was?
I don't know, maybe. It's not right, you know? She wasn't bothering nobody.
I'm only gonna ask you this once. Are you fucking okay?
Yeah. Jesus Christ, are you kidding? My wrists got carpal tunnel from typing. Give me a break.
Megan!
Richard.
Hey, I've been thinking about you ever since I saw... What's wrong?
Do you have a few minutes?
Yeah, come on.
I can't stop the restlessness. I've begun to hallucinate and hear voices again.
I don't suppose you've talked to Dr. Parks about this.
No, no. You know what he'd say.
Well, yeah, he'd say, Megan, I think you should be off the case. I think there's some misguided martyrdom, yada yada, yeah. But still, I don't... just don't know what you're suffering. How that's gonna help those poor children. Best thing you can do is leave Rochester.
I won't stop. It's in my brain now, and it's not gonna let go until I find him.
You do realize that's the disease talking? Okay, I think we're all set. Yeah. Okay, now, here's the thing. If you're not gonna listen to reason, you gotta catch this bastard as soon as you can while you're still in one piece.
I will. Carl Tanner. He's a social worker. He briefly assisted the Castillos.
What's this?
A connection. Carla and Wendy. We interviewed him 2 years ago, but his connection to Carla was only tenuous.
So what's he got to do with Wendy?
He's her father's first cousin.
How come no one notices?
He changed his name. It used to be Walsh, now it's Tanner. There's another thing.
What?
In 1982, he chaperoned a school trip to a canning factory. A 10-year-old got separated from the group, fell from a balcony, and died.
Any evidence of foul play?
No. But it's interesting.
You go over your notes on this guy?
Yes.
What was he like?
Friendly, eager, but not very helpful. How are you gonna handle him?
You found him.
If he's our guy, he likes to feel in control. He thinks he's tricky and clever, but he can only really assert dominance against prepubescent girls.
He's a coward.
Yeah.
So how do we find out if Carl's our boy?
Rattle his cage and see how he does.
Good answer. It's 4 o'clock. Who are the kids?
After school program. Disadvantaged youth, parents with drug problems.
Mr. Tanner.
Yes?
You'd like a word with you?
Sure. Oh, hi. I talked to you a couple years ago about Carla.
Step away from the children, please.
Okay. Sandy, would you watch Jenny for me, please? Thank you. So, what's going on?
How well did you know Wendy Walsh?
You know, I already talked to the policeman from Webster about
Wendy. Answer the question, please.
Well, she was my cousin's kid. We weren't particularly close. Probably met her about half a dozen times.
Why did you change your name?
What the hell's that got to do with anything?
Were you trying to run away from something?
No, I didn't get along with my father.
Children around you have a way of ending up dead.
What?
What about Monica Haley?
Oh, my God, are you people kidding me? That was 15 years ago. I was nowhere near Monica. That was Lydia's fault.
You gotta admit, there are a lot of coincidences.
Look, I didn't do anything wrong. I mean, my God, I work all day to help children. At night, I go home to my wife. Talk to those other cops. I told them everything.
So what do you think?
He's convincing.
Yeah.
You know, it would have helped a hell of a lot, is knowing what Webster got out of him.
No kidding.
Where to next?
Webster.
I'm sorry for the holdup. Detective Harper, Officer Page, your reputation precedes you, young lady.
A mixed blessing, for sure?
Not at all. How can I help you?
As you know, Rochester and Webster are covering a lot of the same ground. We're anxious to pool our resources.
Well, I think that's a great idea. We're going to do everything we can to help you.
Perfect. We'd like to talk to the officers who interviewed Carl Tanner, the social worker.
I'm sorry, but everyone's in the field at the moment.
Well, then we'd like to see the reports.
Carl Tanner. I'll have somebody dig up that information and get it to you just as soon as I can.
We've taken an interest in him as a suspect. We really need to see this today.
Detective Harper, we're real anxious to help you solve the kidnapping aspects of this crime. But it's a little hectic around here at the moment because we're solving a murder, and I just do not have the resources to just drop everything and play fetch for you.
Fuck! Son of a bitch! Well, I guess now Webster's gonna place Carl Tanner at the top of their list.
Yeah. We blew it. I always heard he was an asshole. We should have been ready for it.
We were perfectly reasonable.
And he took it as a challenge, an affront to his authority. We should have flattered him. You're an attractive woman. We could have used that.
What are you saying? You want me to go back and shake my tits for him?
Sorry. I'm just...
I would have done it if I thought it might help.
How you doing?
So you can go back and report to Kenneth?
I'm just concerned.
I'm hanging in there. Thanks.
There's a problem.
What?
10-year-old girl went missing this afternoon.
What's her name?
Melissa Maestro.
I thought you had a unit covering every girl whose initials matched a tap.
You fucked up.
Thank you.
guess Carl Tanner's off the hook.
Meg, what have you come up with so far? Any connections to the other girls?
Melissa and Wendy both attended St. Michael's Church.
And Carla?
She lived in Greece.
Too far a drive for Rochester folk.
Any other commonalities?
Nothing with all three. Melissa and Wendy took gymnastics at the same studio. Different years, different teachers.
Check it out. What else?
Carla and Melissa were both asthmatic. They had different doctors, but we're checking to see if they used the same lab. And Wendy and Melissa had both visited the aquarium in the last year.
It's a stretch. That's all you got? All right. Follow everything. And I want some results, people. All right? I'd rather not have to tell another parent in this community that their child has been murdered, if you don't mind.
There's been another killing.
Oh, Lord.
That's not why I'm calling.
Well, what do you mean?
I'm hallucinating, Richard. And I get these bouts where my hands are shaking all over the place, even though I stopped taking the pills. It's the worst of both worlds.
I'm afraid people are starting to notice.
Well, you know, starting and stopping your medication can be significantly worse than not taking anything at all. The stress isn't good, Megan. Yeah, 216 Frontage. You're relapsing. That's what's happening. And you know why.
Richard, hang on one second.
In the attic, inside the residence at 216
Hello?
Frontage.
He's
armed. I'm sorry, I gotta call you back.
A volunteer at the firehouse named Len Schaefer. He's got a history of mental illness. He's got two hostages up there in his room, his mother and a girl. The suspect allegedly tried to rape the girl. She locked herself in the bathroom, called 911.
How old is she?
19, college student.
19? They like her for the alphabet killings?
Yeah. The girl's name is Elizabeth Eckers.
Len Schaefer.
Yes.
Baker?
What are you doing? You can't go in there, Megan!
Len, I'm gonna come up. Please don't shoot me. Hey, Len. Miss Schaefer? Elizabeth? What's the story?
Beth called the fucking cops, and now they think I killed those girls.
He tried to rape me. I went to the bathroom because he was
You said you were getting a condom!
You know what happens when you drink.
Shut up, Mom!
Len, those cops outside have a lot of ideas.
I didn't kill those girls.
That's obvious. What we need to do is make sure this gets cleared up without anyone getting hurt. Do you know what they're calling this out there? Hostage situation.
Oh, man.
Those fucking bastards!
You know what I see? An argument. Does that make sense?
Yes.
And what do you think, Elizabeth?
He tried to rape me! Which I guess led to an argument.
See? Now, Len, she needs to go.
She's gonna lie about me.
And you'll have the chance to explain that if you let her go. And everyone sees that you don't mean to hurt anyone. This was an argument.
I didn't do anything wrong. I didn't do anything.
Good. We're good.
I just don't like it when everyone's mad at me.
Elizabeth, you can get up now. Elizabeth leave. He put the gun down on the television and he stepped towards the window. He said, I just don't like it when everyone's mad at me. And then he was shot.
Did he pick the gun back up before moving to the window?
No, the gun was on the television when he was shot.
Sorry, I got here as soon as I could. Megan, a word?
Gun was on the table.
Yeah, well, there are half a dozen cops who say that Schaefer was making a threatening gesture with him.
Well, they're lying. They escalated the conflict. That guy was not the killer. He could barely tie his own fucking shoes.
Oh, and that makes him innocent?
Elizabeth was 19 years old, for Christ's sakes. And you know what he called her? Beth. No one even called her Elizabeth.
Meg. The DNA test came back. The cat hair that was in his house was a positive match. It was positive.
Look, that doesn't make sense. The gun was on the table, Ken. That's the truth.
Listen, Len Schaefer kept that girl hostage for 2 hours at gunpoint. He was ranting and dangerous.
The cop who fired saw an opening and took it. I'd have done the same thing. So would you. It was a righteous shooting, okay? Now, you want to contest the fine points? Go ahead. You'll lose. There'll be a hearing into your conduct in the matter. Oh, yeah. And the board will find that you were delusional, that you disobeyed an order, and you endangered lives. And you'll be fired, and I'll be censured, most likely demoted for putting you on the case. This whole thing has been embarrassing enough, Megan.
But it makes no sense. Do you know what everyone calls her?
Beth, you told me that already. Now, where was the gun, Meg?
Good evening. We believe that the man who the press labeled as the Alphabet Killer was shot and killed this evening. The suspect's name was Len Schaefer. He was an employee of the Webster Fire Department. He may have been using a fireman's uniform to lure his victims into his vehicle. When the police arrived on the scene this evening, he was holding a young lady at gunpoint, a young lady who had double initials in her name. The suspect was allegedly trying to rape the young lady when the police intervened. He brandished a weapon at the officers. The officers shot and killed him. The young lady suffered no injuries. She's recovering well. We're still gathering evidence, but I think it's safe to say that this dark chapter in our community's history is coming to an end. Are there any questions?
I wanted to catch you before you left. You okay? Hey, Megan. I wanted to say it was actually nice working with you. I'm sorry it ended this way.
No, it's all right. I've still got my job in the records department for now. You don't think Len Schaefer committed those murders, do you?
I don't know. It's certainly not the way I imagined it.
Are you still on the case?
Another week or two to close the files. This has been a tough one, Meg.
I just have a few questions about the abduction so that I could tie up some loose ends.
You know, I'm surprised you're still on the job. But of course, we'll share any information we have.
Now that you got the collar.
That's correct.
When did you know that the Alphabet Killer was Len Schaefer?
He assaulted a young girl with double initials. The color of his personal car matched, and when the tests from the cat hair came back positive, we were pretty sure that confirmed it.
Your men found the cat hair when they searched Len's house.
First the car, then the house. Yes.
I saw some as well, the cat hair.
You've been back to the crime scene. Isn't that interesting? Who gave you permission?
The cat hair was only on one chair.
Probably his favorite.
You know, there was something very strange, though.
And what was that?
There was no cat food in the house. There was no litter, either.
Well, he probably crapped outside.
What did he eat?
Mice. He ate mice.
I think that you planted that evidence. I think that you planted that cat fur.
You get the fuck out of my office right now.
Why did you do it? Did you plant the evidence to ensure Schaefer's conviction, or were you covering something up?
I didn't do a goddamn thing. But let me tell you something. If someone did, in theory, do something to protect the public, to close the book on a wretched killer, even if it was against the rules, then I'd have to say this person did the right thing.
Unless this person had the wrong guy, then children continue to die.
You know, I heard you were crazy. Now you go on now. Get out. Get out.
Hey, you're that policewoman.
Yeah. You're the bartender from Richmond's.
Yeah, Hank. Good memory. You come in and spoke with Jay Castillo a few times, a couple years ago.
Carla Castillo's father. That's right. How's he doing?
He's stopped drinking. It's a start.
So you don't see much of him anymore?
Oh, I see him all the time. We're neighbors.
Did you know Carla?
Yeah. Nice kid.
Did you notice anything different about her before she was killed?
No. Well, I didn't see much of her then. She stopped coming around about 6 months earlier.
What are you talking about?
Oh, you didn't know. They had a big fight. Jay's drinking got pretty bad at that point.
Listen, take care.
Yeah, sure.
Bert Carlego on Tuesday afternoons.
It's been a long time.
2 years.
Why'd you lie, Jay?
I was a shit father. I wasn't fit to take care of her. Not even for a few hours. One night, I got drunk. And I yelled at her. So bad. I had her go with her grandmother after that.
For how long?
6 months or so.
Why would your wife disapprove?
My mother, she's very Catholic. She gave Carla that necklace. And if my wife...
Where did your mother take her on Tuesdays?
St. Michael's. A church in Rochester.
Megan.
I found a connection. Carla went to St. Michael's on Tuesdays, not her father's.
Megan, you are in a world of shit. Norcross called me, screaming his head off about you.
Ken, St. Michael's is the connection. All three girls went there. I'm going there right now.
No, you are not. You're coming in right now. I swear to God, I'm going to send a patrol car to that church and bring you...
My name is Megan Page. I'm a detective with the Rochester Police Department. I'm gonna need some information.
Do you have any,
I need to talk to you.
Of course. This way.
And I'm gonna need lists of everyone who's been involved in this church in the last 5 years. Priests, parishioners, janitors, whoever else I'm not thinking of.
You know, the church will help the police any way we can, but I can't provide you with information about our parishioners without permission.
Can you call someone and get that permission?
I can try.
Excuse me?
Do you pray for the angels who were called back to heaven?
Yes, I
guess so.
That's good.
What the hell is this?
They were our own angels.
What is wrong with you? What is that goddamn music?
There's no music. Oh no.
Fuck.
Oh. Oh.
Fuck.
Oh no. No.
Please. What the fuck?
Oh.
What the... God. God. Oh. Deja vu.
Megan, how are you feeling?
My head hurts. Was Captain Shine here?
He left about 5 minutes ago.
Shit. I have to talk to him.
He'll be back.
Not good enough.
Hold on, Meg. You shouldn't leave. It's not what you need right now.
Shouldn't leave or can't leave? Do you have a court order?
We do. We have 14 days to observe you, but the point is, we all want what's best for you. We're all in this together.
Did you put me on Thorazine?
You were having a violent episode when you arrived. It's just to give you some clarity.
Fuck that.
Meg. Nurse, send Alex in here, please. Megan, you're delusional. It's the disease that makes you want to do this.
I am a detective, Dr. Parks. I have a case to solve.
You're not a detective, Meg. You were a detective. You're sick now.
I'm warning you, Dr. Parks. Do not impede this investigation.
You remember when you wanted to kill yourself? This is the same thing. It's your sickness, Meg. Megan? Meg. Meg, let's just calm down and think about what's best.
What do you want me to do?
Let her think. Wait, wait, Alex, wait, no!
Down, down, down! Easy, easy. You follow me out and I will break your other arm. Parks, you're a nice man, and I will not hit you unless you come out of this room before I'm gone.
My house staked out. They're messing around.
Well, listen, you can stay here as long as you can stand the company. Have you got a plan?
I'm gonna break into that church and find their records.
Oh, Megan, I don't think you're in any shape for that.
I feel okay. I need a nap. Maybe it's the Thorazine, but I can still tell what's real. The pictures on the wall were real.
Don't you think the police will be looking into the church now that you've established a link?
Who knows? And they found a way to botch every other aspect of this investigation. Maybe they're planning on giving that creepy fucking priest the keys to the city. I sound like a lunatic.
No, you just need to get a little sleep.
Richard?
You're up.
Richard.
What are you doing in here?
Why didn't you tell me you knew the victims?
Then you would know I killed them.
I didn't hit you too hard. You know, I love you, Megan. I really do, but don't worry, you're not my type. Your virtue is safe with me. The first one, Carla, well, I did that because, well, I don't know why I did it, actually. I guess because I wanted to. But, you know, I didn't even realize I was taking her to Churchville. Isn't that ironic? You know, when I first met you, you told me about your obsession with initials. Well, I was just trying to help you get your job back. You know, I was just trying to make you right, don't you see? And I just thought in that way you and I would be more connected with each other. Yeah. Okay. My only friend, Megan, it's gonna be awful losing you. Stay calm. We're only going a few blocks. Genesee. Wow. Doesn't that sound nice?
She's delusional, violent, resistant to treatment. She's determined to fight her way out again.
This is all my fault.
Her illness is nobody's fault.
I was hoping I could talk to her.
She's unable to communicate. She's very heavily medicated. We had to put her in the quiet room.
Every day I'm in here is a day he's out there. My only remaining purpose is to get out. The dead have given me their answers, and the dead won't let me forget them. I will get out, and I will kill him.